Yamaha DX7 was released in 1983. It uses FM synthesis, which is very different from subtractive synthesis found in typical analog synthesizers. No VCO, no VCF, no VCA. FM synthesis uses frequency modulation to generate a sound. Instead of a VCO, it uses operator, which only generates a sine wave. You can adjust pitch or frequency ratio, envelope generator, scaling, output level, and velocity sensitivity for each operator. Because all six operators only produce a sine wave, you need to rearrange those operators in order to generate harmonic rich tones. These arrangements are called algorithm, and this is the most important part of the DX7 FM synthesis. In a simple term, a carrier operator acts like a VCA, controlling the volume of a sound. A modulator acts like a VCF, controlling harmonic contents of a sound. Because a modulator can produce harmonic rich tones, you don't need a VCF to control its harmonic contents. The DX7 has 32 algorithms, giving a wide possibility of sound design. For example, algorithm 32 is the simplest algorithm. Each operator independently generates a sine wave. There is no frequency modulation, so you have a pure additive synthesis. You can make an organ sound or even a bell sound by adding 6 sine waves. Algorithm 5 is a bit more complex. 2 operator stacking with 3 towers. You can make a bell and electric piano type sounds. Algorithm 2 has only 2 towers and having many operators stacked on top of one another. You can create a sound packed with higher harmonics, like string sound. Most complex algorithms are ones that has only one carrier operator and the rest of operators are stacked on top of one another. They are pure FM synthesis algorithms which can produce harmonic rich and complex sounds, such as brass sounds. You will notice that a certain operator in each algorithm has a feedback loop. You can control the amount of feedback by its level and output level. Feedback allows an operator to generate higher harmonic rich tones, such as sawtooth wave. You also need to adjust the operator's frequency ratio to generate particular harmonics. The ratio of 1 to 1 for carrier and modulator generates a sawtooth sound. The ratio of 1 to 2 for carrier and modulator generates a square sound. Metallic bell sound is produced by having the ratio of 1 to 3.5, producing an inharmonic tone. For a typical analog synth, you only have 2 oscillators for detuning. For the DX7, you have 6 oscillators for detuning, so you can get an amazing and beautiful chorusing effect, like this DX7 epic pad sound. To control harmonic contents and volume over time, you will use an envelope generator. Unlike an ADSR type envelope for analog synthesizers, the DX7 envelopes are more flexible, having 8 parameters per envelope. There are 4 parameters to control rate or speed, and 4 parameters to control level amount. Because output level sets the maximum level of modulation output for modulators and volume for carriers, envelope generator and output level go hand in hand in order to fine-tune sound. To control harmonics contents over sound like using a VCF, you adjust envelope and output level of a modulator. To control volume, like using a VCA, you adjust envelope and output level of a carrier. In order to give expressiveness to a sound, use key velocity sensitivity. To control an overall volume, apply it to carrier operators. To control harmonic contents, apply it to modulator operators. Let's revise what we've learned so far. Algorithm is the most important part of FM synthesis. Feedback allows you to generate a sawtooth wave. Frequency ratio allows you to generate necessary harmonics for a particular sound. Detune allows you to generate a beautiful chorusing effect using all 6 operators. Envelope has 8 parameters with more flexibility. Envelope and output level can act like VCF for modulator and VCA for carrier. Key velocity sensitivity gives you expressiveness to the DX7 FM synthesis.